The U.S. Supreme Court handed President Trump one of the biggest victories of his presidency Tuesday, upholding his travel ban restricting travel to the U.S. for foreign nationals from 7 countries. The court ruled 5-4 along ideological lines in favor of the Trump administration in the case, which marked the first time one of Trump's policies was reviewed by the justices. Trump quickly praised the decision in a tweet. Chief Justice John Roberts delivered the opinion for the majority. Justice Anthony Kennedy, the crucial swing vote in the case, sided with the conservative justices. Writing for the majority, Roberts said the president's travel executive order is squarely within the scope of presidential authority under federal immigration law. The proclamation is expressly premised on legitimate purposes, preventing entry of nationals who cannot be adequately vetted and inducing other nations to improve their practices, Roberts wrote. The text says nothing about religion. The case involved a challenge to the third iteration of Trump's travel ban, which he signed in September 2017. The order placed restrictions on foreign nationals traveling to the U.S. from 8 countries that Trump said were unable to determine whether its immigrants have terrorist backgrounds. 6 of those countries have Muslim majority populations. 2 of the countries identified in the executive order, North Korea and Venezuela, were excluded from the court challenge, and a 3rd, Chad, was removed from the list after the White House said it improved its information sharing processes. Challengers of Trump's third travel ban said the policy violated the Constitution and federal immigration law. They also argued the ban discriminates on the basis of religion, and cited Trump's campaign statements and tweets showing anti-Muslim videos as evidence of that discrimination. But the Trump administration argued the president was acting within his authority under federal immigration law in issuing his executive order in September. The proclamation, the administration said, was issued only after a government-wide review determined which countries had inadequate vetting policies for travelers looking to come to the U.S. Roberts and the majority rejected the challenger's argument that the specific number of countries with Muslim majority populations included in the executive order demonstrates Trump acted with animus toward Muslims, saying that alone does not support an inference of religious hostility. The justices heard arguments in the case in April on the term's last day for arguments.